So then, the year is MMXV. Yes, MMXV. That's the year, that's what I'm going to call it. 2015. Welcome to 2015 and welcome to Novabug's channel. If you're tuning in for the first time, I've never opened a video like that before. But anyway, this is a New Year's update video, a channel, where the channel's going to be going, what I've got plans for, hopefully, for future shows, collaborations, a few adjustments to some of my existing programming. Sounds so professional, don't I? I'm not at all. And of course, the big finale to Retro Master Mindless, which people have been bugging the bug about. Yes, I know I was slacking. Had a lot of things. The Jingle Bells video that I did in December really took a lot out of my time. So that will be done in January. Three shows, special shows, to get Retro Master Mindless all wrapped up in a nice little tight package. Promise you, I will. And I'll be talking about Retro Master Mindless in a minute. But the first thing I want to chat about is my collection and where it's headed. I had an idea over Christmas, and this was kind of inspired by my brother as well. He decided that he's got a large collection of PlayStation 4 stuff now, so he's decided that he wants to go for the full collection, full physical collection. So not downloadable stuff, just stuff that's released on disc in the UK. So I thought, that's good, that's quite a nifty idea actually, and it's the first time he's ever done anything like that. Now, as opposed to all the systems I collect for, there's only one that I collect specifically for a full collection. As you know, that's the Amstrad GX4000. But that is a very long-winded, very expensive process, and it probably will never come to fruition. So I want to give myself a goal of a project, of a collection project, which could possibly come to fruition. A bit like Tutti's collection of Master System games is, but for a modern system. So I've chosen, obviously, the Wii U. So my goal now, for my collecting aim, obviously I'm still sticking with the Amstrad stuff, of course. Never stop collecting for the Amstrad. Both the GX and the CPC. But also, for a full collection, I'm going for the Wii U. UK releases only. Physical copies only. No download stuff, just physical discs. This raises a few issues. Namely, I have to buy a lot of dirge to get a full collection, but anybody that collects a full set of games for that system will know, feel that. And also, I'll have to do some. Got a bit windy. Tea, give me a bit of wind, because I'm off the beer now at the moment. This month, off the beer. But the tea's going cold, and my Pac-Man mugs, bits of it are coming off. Never mind. Anyway, I digress. I'll have to get a load of dirge for it. I'll have to get things like Barbie Dreamhouse something or other, and Angry Fucking Birds and shit like that, which I would never in a million years buy normally, but to get for the whole point of getting a full collection, I will find them. Obviously, I'm not going to pay full price for them. I'll pick them up in due course, wherever source, wherever place, wherever resource. But after a good start now, because I've got 12 Wii U games and I've got several on the system. That's another little annoyance, because I'll have to buy the games on physical from what I've already got and downloaded on the system, like Wii Sports Club, for instance. Which originally was only download anyway, and now it's out as a physical release. So I'll effectively end up buying it twice, which is a pity. And Nintendo Land as well. So aside from that, really excited about it, because people gripe about saying, oh, there's no games for the Wii U. You know what, there's over 450 games out for it. Yeah, there's shitloads. A lot of them are just, they've gone under the radar, and of course several, I'd say about, half of them are probably download only, or a third of them at least. But anyway, I'll get the definitive UK release list, and we're working through them. So, that's kind of where I'm heading on the modern gaming scene. On the retro gaming scene, of course, the Amstrad is a mainstay on my channel, and it always will be. That's what the main focus is. And of course, SNES, Mega Drive, PlayStation, of course, all them. Now, a couple of new shows I've got planned. Nothing set in, well, I was about to say nothing set in concrete. It's set, sort of set in semi-pliable clay. So it's nearly there, but not quite. I'm working on a show with Gashead Steve. And we're going to do this. We are going to do this. Where it's kind of a tournament challenge show, where it's me versus him. And we're going to call it Home and Away. Home and Away. You know, like the Australian sitcom. Was it a sitcom? No, it was a drama, was it? Or soap. Oh, apparently it was a soap. Didn't a ghost appear in that show once? Not into ghosts, just a ghost. Anyway, yeah. So the idea is we're going to cross do this. We're going to do this cross channel. So one show will be on my channel, and then the next episode will be on his channel, and so on and so forth. So the home episodes for me will be on my channel, and my away episodes will be on his channel from his home perspective. If you follow, and it's quite straightforward. We are open to any platform. We are open to any game, obviously two-player game, like a head-to-head game. Excuse me. And the rules are, there are no rules. Know the rules of Home and Away. Home and Away, the rules are, there's only one rule of Home and Away, and that's play games and have a laugh. And that's basically it. Gameplay footage, they're not going to be massively long videos. Because we want to make them watchable, so they're going to be succinct. They're going to have a little bit of brevity about them. So we choose. I choose, for instance, for my home leg, which will kick off. I choose a game, and we set a personal sort of best around five or something like that, whatever the game would be, and then we play that. And then whoever the victor is, we tick a point, and then we go to the away leg. And we're going to be doing this monthly. We're hoping to get at least one show out per month, so that's 12 episodes throughout the year. So six homes and six aways. So six on my channel and six on Steve's channel. All different games and all different systems. We haven't decided what the systems are yet, all the games, so they could be anything. And I think that's the fun of it. When it's in, say for instance, my home leg, I can pick any game I want. Steve does not have a choice. I pick the game and we play it. And then the opposite goes for the away leg from my perspective. So I think it should be a lot of fun, and it's we're looking forward to filming it. We really are, and we're going to be filming the first couple of episodes very soon indeed. So hopefully that'll be on the channel. The first episode will be on the channel by the end of the month, hopefully. But there is one thing that might get in the way, and that is Retro Master Mindless. This has got to be sorted out, got to be finished, and it's going to be finished. We've got the top seven here. Chris Shank, Monkey Spurs, 5000. Really missed that bit out, James. Harry Yak, Dan Central, Lacto, Basilius Protem, Console Snob, and JL76 Gaming. And what I'm going to do now, right now, I'm going to pull this on you guys. I'm going to draw your semi-final. Okay? So, JL76. So what we're going to do is I'm going to draw four names from this hat, and those four names will play each other in the first semi-final. The three remaining names, sorry, I didn't show you that one. Three remaining names will be in the other semi-final. Scott the Console Snob, in there. Dan Central. And that's the fairest way I could work it out, because I didn't want to pair the top three up with the four below. Didn't show you that one either, did I? Fucking hell. That was Lactobacillus Prime. So it's going to be complete random, and we'll just draw them all out together. Of course, I think the leaders won't be too happy about that. I'm folding them up. I'm not showing you, am I? Monkey Spats, 5000, which I haven't written down there. Harry Yak. And Christopher Ashanshish. So that's how we're going to do it, and the two episodes will be filmed very soon, as I can get the guys ready and up and running. because questions are ready. So just do a case of contacting them. So anyway, the first semi-final will be contested by Dan Central. Scott the console snob. They're probably saying, I don't want to get Chris as they're watching this now. Well, you've got Chris. Chris is shanked. And Harold Rutherford Yak. So that will be the first semi-final. And of course the second semi-final will be the remaining guys. So that will be Monkey, Spares, here, there he is, JR76 and Lacto, Basilius Prior. So they will, that's what the two episodes will be. And, well, actually I'll stop there because I'll let you know on the surprise twist I'm putting on. The twist. Excellent. But you'll see that in the show. Anyway, so that after that's finished, there'll be one victor from both semi-finals. They will play each other in a final episode head-to-head, and the victor of Retro Master Minus Season 1 will be crowned. And at that point, I'll have to say farewell to Retro Master Minus for this year. I am putting her on the back burner for the moment. May return late in the year, I'm considering it, but Retro Master Minus will just take a back seat for now. Since I will have 11 episodes of Season 1. A couple of reasons for this. You can imagine there's a lot of work that goes into writing an episode of Retro Master Mind. There's a lot of research. So it is time consuming. Not that I don't mind. I love making it. I love filming it and I think it's a great show. I sound blowing my own bleeding trumpet there, am I? Shit, I shouldn't have done that because someone's going to take that clip now and loop it. Fuck you, Steve or Infected or whoever takes that. Anyway, that aside, and also I've got a replacement show for Retro Master Mindless, and this will be a bi-monthly show which I've been working on ideas with a few other YouTubers on it, and it will be a live stream, but it's slightly different. It won't be sort of like a general blah 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 manic live stream. It's a live stream with a focus. I've got an idea, and just to have planned guests, so it's not like everyone jumping in. I will be the host, of course, and then I have two, maximum three guests, and it will be a debate show. A debate show where I will come up with a topic, and I want to hear everyone's side of the debate. And this obviously includes a bit of banter, a bit of fact, maybe a little bit of arguing, but we're going to try and keep it as light-hearted as possible, and that's my aim. And that will be called predictably the bug stream. So the bug stream will be coming towards you very, very soon. Hopefully get the first episode of the bug stream done in February. I've already got one guest already lined up, sort of like the pilot episode, as it were. It's also not going to be a very lengthy live stream. I want to keep it, like I said, succinct and to the point. So it'll be a maximum an hour and a half long, maximum. I'm hoping that most shows will be an hour long, because we don't want to sort of like get into a situation where we're just sitting there scratching our heads and itching our balls and all that kind of stuff. It's got to be to the point and banter, bang, go, 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 and all that. And that's what I want it to be like. With me acting as a devil's advocate, which I will take great pleasure in. But I'm very excited for it. So, very excited for it, and yeah, and I hope you will too, because I'm looking for something to be a bit more interactive with you guys. Retro Master Minus is that, but it's, I suppose a lot of people, because it's a game show, I think a lot of people might be turned off with the idea of a cheesy game show, and that's in essence what it is. So this is more open, a lot can go wrong with a live stream, as you know, so it should be quite fun. Right. Yeah, sorry, I hate jump cuts, but I had a jump cut there because my camera was flashing at me and telling me something that it lied, basically. It lied. It didn't tell me that... it didn't tell me what? I fucking don't know. Anyway, to wrap this update show up, update waffle, whatever you want to call it, is the, again, slight changes to my programming as it is at the moment. The NRGs, I've currently got 5 different versions of the NRG videos. So you have the standard 5 to 10 minutes, kind of review gameplay kind of things. Then you have the 20 minute extended, and then you have the extra, you have the complete playthrough. And you have 4 then, you don't have 5. Because you're going to have 5 soon. 5's coming at you soon. Big 5, high 5, low 5, too slow. And we're going to have an NRG which will pop up now and then, a bit like the NRG extras. It will just pop up now and then, but it will be quite a long one, probably a 30-minute job, and it will be talking about one when you get that compilation discs on the PlayStation, compilation programs on the CPC, type-ins, that kind of stuff, and I'll be just playing each game on that disc or on that media format or whatever it may be, going through them in short, brief little bite-sized chunks, and yeah, seeing how that compilation works out. Obviously not compilations of released games. I'm not talking about them, I'm talking about things like, you know, bulk games of crap, load of shit games on one disc. Some of them actually end up quite good, but that's the kind of thing I'm aiming for. So that'd be an extra NRG to the roster. And NRGs will be... I sometimes sort of chuck out random NRGs now, but I have been doing actually since I started. But what I'm going to make sure to do soon is to get at least one NRG per week. So you'll have 52 NRGs in a year, no matter what that NRG may be. Maybe it's a traditional 5 to 10 minute one, or a 20 minute longer one, or a complete playthrough, or something like that. So, yeah, so basically that's it. These are the plans I've got. Like I said, nothing's set completely in fast drying concrete yet, but near enough. It's nearly dry. It's nearly cured. Nearly gone off. That's probably what all you lot have done right now, is gone off, switched off, fucked off. And you know what, I wouldn't blame you. But anyway, please stick with me, please. It'll be fun, I hope. So yeah, that's it. We'll be seeing you soon for Retro Masterminders once I've got the filming all done for that. And of course, please tune in to our new show, Home and Away, me and Gashead Steve. That'll be coming very soon, the next couple of weeks, hopefully. So thank you very much for watching. And have a great 2015, whatever you do. Be good, be good. Be excellent to each other, as Bill and Ted said. It worked out all right for them, didn't it? They passed their history test. So, on that note, have a good 2015. Thanks for the support. Thanks for watching my channel. Thanks for seeing this mouth open, flap up and down. Be good. Nova Bug.